Hello and welcome to the France 24 interview. My guest today is the Foreign Minister of Turkey, Mevlüt Çavuşoğlu. Thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you.
Mr. Minister, you were with your president in Iran. One of the main topics of discussion was obviously the referendum held in the Kurdish region of Iraq recently, a referendum on independence that you've opposed, staunchly opposed. We've heard that there would be some kind of retaliation. What exactly will happen? We've heard President Erdogan saying the airspace, the border with that region would be closed soon. What is going to happen?
Thank you very much. Of course, the referendum in Iraq, Kurdish region, was one of the issues that we discussed because Iran and Turkey are neighboring countries. So such development will have impact on us as well. Therefore, we discussed this issue in depth. And obviously, we have the same position. The airspace has been already closed upon the decision of Iraq. And therefore, there is no flight between Turkey and Erbil or Süleymaniye. And three Turkish companies, including Turkish Airlines, were flying to Erbil. Now they are not flying anymore. And with regards to the border, these are the border between Turkey and Iraq, not border between Turkey and Kurdish regional authorities. Okay, so we have all this, we signed the agreements in the past with Iraq. Therefore, with regards to the border control issue, our counterpart is Baghdad. Therefore, the request and the decision and action of Baghdad will be the basis for Turkey's decisions and actions as well.
The president also said we need more decisive action. I mean, the airspace is one thing, the border is one thing. The key action, besides military action, which I believe is not right now on the horizon, would be to shut down the oil pipeline going from the Kurdish region to Turkey. Obviously, this is a lifeline for the Kurdish region, but it's also important for Turkey. Are you ready to shut that pipeline if the Kurdish authorities don't change their mind about independence?
Well, first, we have been calling on Kurdish authorities, Barzani administration, to change their decision, and which has been a
they've refused.
Big mistake. And not only Turkey, everybody is calling on them, actually.
But they refuse to change.
They haven't refused yet. Since the referendum, they have been quiet. But before the referendum, including France and United States and our allies, everybody called on Kurdish regional government to stop that process or to postpone. But they refuse, and they didn't get any support from international community, and they don't have that support. So in this case, such decision actually was a grave mistake. And I believe that it will not bring any further right to Kurdish brothers and sisters there. And this is actually what I explained him in a very friendly manner when I was in Erbil. And he is risking the future of the Kurds in Iraq. And it will have a lot of negative impact
for the region. But are you ready to close that pipeline?
Well, this
yes
is,
or no?
This is if the request comes from Baghdad, we will seriously consider that.
But it's a sovereign decision. You could decide we are not happy, so we are shutting down this life.
I told you at the beginning, our counterpart is Baghdad, Iraq, and the request coming from Baghdad and their decisions and the actions will be a basis or criteria for our own action. We have already taken some decisions and actions, and Ministerial Council, the Parliament, and the National Security Council. So we have been repeating that our counterpart is Baghdad. So decisions and the requests coming from Baghdad will be a kind of criteria for our own decision and action.
I've heard, and including in Iran, President Erdogan talk about this referendum as a plot by the Israeli intelligence service, the Mossad, saying this was, at the same time, you're trying to restore diplomatic relations with Israel. I mean, does he really think, do you really think that Israel engineered this referendum?
Well, the whole world called on the authorities to cancel or to suspend or to postpone the referendum. He didn't. And the support came only from Israel, from Netanyahu and a few other political figures. But after the referendum, we haven't seen that. But the photos have been circulated that Barzani and Mossad agents have been working there. So this it has been covered everywhere. Therefore, not only in Turkey, but internationally. Therefore, there is an impression that they supported this referendum.
It's not only so, supporting, that they engineered it, that they were the reason? Well, you really think that?
Well, this is the impression that we got.
But how can you continue talking to Israel if that's the case?
Why we shouldn't talk Israel? You don't have to agree with every country on everything, okay? And disagreeing on this doesn't mean that you should actually suspend all the bilateral issues.
So that's not
we
going
just
to
normalize. Of course, we criticize Israel when they make mistake. This is for sure, or vice versa. But when you disagree each time, you cannot actually cut all your
so that's
ties.
Not going
this
to
is, yeah, this is another issue.
I want to get to.
And this is not only Turkey's matter. I mean, this referendum is, I mean, very sensitive issue for us. But it is not only the matter of Turkey, it is a matter of the region, those countries, neighboring countries, and the entire world and the international community.
I want to get...
So does it mean that an entire international community should cut the ties with Israel?
I want to get to the U.S. There have been tensions over a variety of things. There's tension after the arrest of a local employee of the U.S. consulate in Istanbul who was accused of spying, of trying to overthrow the state. The U.S. mission in Turkey said, I'm quoting, the allegations are wholly without merit. What's your reaction?
Well, working here or there don't give immunity to anybody, okay? If anybody commits any kind of crime, subject to investigation and the legal judicial process. This is for sure. In Turkey, nobody can be detained or arrested or imprisoned without any serious accusation and without any serious preliminary finding or the evidences. And at the end, it is up to the independent judiciary to give the judgment, not up to politicians, not up to me. Then not up to State Department.
So you're saying this case is serious and not fabricated?
There are serious accusations and the evidences. Since he is working for a diplomatic mission, I was also informed and I asked actually the authorities, I mean judiciary and the authorities in Istanbul, they told me that there are serious findings and the evidences. Therefore, in this case, it doesn't matter where he or she works.
But when the U.S. says it's without merit, it's a little bit like all the people who've been arrested and the West says it's without merit.
Well, this is nonsense, I have to say. I mean, when it happens in those countries, independent judiciary. We have also independent judiciary. And nobody can intervene here. And in Turkey, no cases, no judicial cases are politically motivated, okay? So nobody asked anybody. We didn't know who that person was. I mean, working for a mission is not a kind of crime in Turkey. But if anybody is involved any kind of crime or involved of any illegal activities, subject to investigation and the judicial process. And this is what everybody must understand.
So do you think that this will maybe complicate further your efforts, your calls, for the U.S. to extradite Fethullah Gulen, the exiled cleric, who is accused by the regime of being behind the coup.
It shouldn't.
This is not making any progress.
We can face this kind of situation anywhere in any country. Okay, and in Europe also there are Turkish citizens arrested, detained, imprisoned. So we have the bilateral agreements, cooperation agreements. We have been working with many countries like that, and we have also bilateral agreements with United States, including the extradition of such persons. And we have already transmitted all the evidences that Gülen himself and his cult is behind the attempted coup in Turkey. Therefore, we ask our counterparts in the United States to start the investigation, in-depth investigation there, and also to extradite him to Turkey.
That's not happening.
In the line of all this evidence. I mean, so far, it didn't happen, and this is one of the actually issue in our relations, I can say.
So you're upset that you see no progress on
of
this?
Of course, we are disappointed, and it has been affecting the emotions of Turkish people.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mevlüt Çavuşoğlu. Thank you for watching this edition of the interview here on Friends 24.